This was the capacitor voltage, voltage across the capacitor. And it is a triangular wave. During this point, capacitor is charging. Here it is discharging. A to B it is discharging. B to C it is again charging. C to D discharging, and so on and so forth. Similarly, the inductor capacitor, you connect an inductor in series with RL, and this is how the input waveform is. So during the first half cycle, D1 is forward biased, current flows through D1, L, RL. During the negative half cycle, the second diode is forward biased, so the current flow is through D2, L, and RL. In both the cases, the current through the load resistor remains the same. So now, with these two in mind, let me now talk about the mathematical calculations. Let me now start with the mathematical analysis of inductor and C filters. L is called inductor filter and C is called capacitor filter. So to understand this is you are making use of what is known as your Fourier analysis. What I discussed now, we are using Fourier analysis for doing these mathematical predictions. So let me now start with, first we will start with a capacitor filter, then we will go to inductor filter. Okay? So, shall we start with inductor filter? So, you have seen how the inductor filter is, right? And the Fourier output voltage, we have represented either a voltage or the current, was represented by Vm, okay, into 2 by pi minus 4 by 3 pi, just now we have seen, cos of theta minus 4 by 15 pi 15 pi cos of 4 theta and so on. This was what we have given. Okay. Now, here when you see, you have to find the ripple factor. What was the ripple factor? The fluctuating or the AC component present, the AC component which is present in the output voltage or current was referred to as the ripple. Okay? Or it is also fluctuating DC. Also referred to as the fluctuating component. So now to find this, you need what is the amount of AC and what is the amount of DC. Once you know this, you will be able to calculate your factor. So when you look at this expression here, you can see the first term is independent of frequency. There is no frequency component here. Here and here you have frequency component coming. Because theta is equal to, what is theta? What is the relation between theta and omega? Theta is equal to omega t. That means this is cos 2 omega t, this is cos 4 omega t. The fourth component and This is the second component. The one which depends on the frequency is referred to as the AC component, and if it is a term which is independent of the frequency is called as the DC. So the first term is your DC component. Second, third, etc. are all AC components. And let us consider only up to second frequency component, that means up to cos 2 omega t or cos 2 theta only. Let me consider. If you consider that, then the DC component is VDC is given by 2VM by pi, and the AC component is given by, what is it given by? 4VM by 3 pi cos 2 theta. 4VM by 3 pi, 4VM by 3 pi cos theta, that is 4Vm by 3 pi cos of 2 omega t. Now if you want to calculate the ripple, we need the RMS value. How do you get the RMS value? RMS value will be peak value by. Now let me write down the voltage developed across RL. How did we connect? You have an rectifier circuit here. You connected an inductor in series and RL here. This was inductor. So what is the voltage that is developed across RL? You are applying voltage divider network. When you apply voltage divider network, what you get is, when you apply this, what you get is voltage across RL, VRL by XL RL, because the inductive reactance is given by XL. So your first year Thevenin's relation is what I am using. So if you use that relation, then voltage developed across RL is given by, what is the voltage? 4Vm by 3 by the maximum value, let me just consider this, into what is the drop across RL divided by RL square plus XL square. I think you know this relation. I am just considering. What am I considering? I am considering the maximum value. What is the maximum value? The frequency component is cos 2 theta, but its amplitude is 4Vm by 3. This is the amplitude. This is only the frequency component. So what am I getting here? What we are getting is 4Vm by 3 pi into RL, voltage drop across RL, divided by RL square plus XL square is the total reactance of the circuit. What is reactance? This is a RL, XL. Reactance means that is the total impedance of the circuit contributing from the load as well as this. So therefore, now the RMS value is given by 4Vm by 3 pi into 2 into RL, the same expression, RL square plus XL square, XL square, and this is the root. So now, what is your ripple? Ripple is represented by the letter R, that is VRMS by DC. So 4VM by 3 pi into 2 into RL by RL square plus XL square into, what do you get? What was your VDC? 2VM by pi. So you get it as pi by 2M. Okay, so now, what are you getting? So your Vm, Vm gets cancelled, pi, pi get cancelled, 2 is 2 times, let me write this expression here as equal to, this is root 2 and 2, so can I write it as root 2 by 3 into Rl by Rl square plus XL square under root. Which can further be written as equal to, let me take RL common. So RL, when you take it out of the square, it is RL 1 plus XL square by RL square under root. There is an RL here. So this RL get cancelled, and what you are left with is only your gamma is equal to root 2 by 3 into 1 by XL square by RL square root. And what was the condition that we said? XL is equal to, what is XL is equal to? Omega L. But why am I writing 2 omega? Because I am taking the second component, 2 omega. Therefore, it is 2 omega n. So, using this relation, what do I get? I get it as root 2 by 3 into 1 by 1 plus 4 omega square, omega n, 4 omega square n square by r n square root. So, now let us apply the condition that we take an inductance to be very large. So, omega square L square, 4 of course is a constant, by R L square. If this happens to be very large compared to 1, this 1 can be neglected. If this 1 is neglected, then you get this as equal to root 2 by 3 into square root goes, then it is RL by 2 omega L, and that is equal to RL by, there is a 2 here, so root 2, 3 root 2, something like that. You get 3 root 2, thus this is omega suffix L goes. Omega, thus of this condition, which condition have we taken? We have taken this condition of this relation. Okay, so next relation is, from here what do you conclude? Just write down, from here what we conclude is, as RL increases, since gamma is proportional to RL, the ripple also increases. So if RL decreases, gamma is proportional to, since it is proportional to RL, ripple also decreases. So what is the conclusion here is, that means if RL is high, the pull is increasing. If RL is low, the pull is decreasing. This is a very important concept here. So we can conclude that inductor filter is effective. We want ripple to be less. When will the ripple be less? When load resistance is zero. So it is effective for small load resistance. If the resistance is small, that means voltage is very high. So for heavy load voltages, this inductor is effective. Also, one more conclusion is, it is, what is it? Oh, L is in the denominator. Since L, omega L is in the denominator, what is omega L again? 2 pi FL, isn't it? 2 pi F. So since it is inversely proportional to the frequency, it acts as a block to low frequency and it allows high frequency. Because as L is increased, L is in the denominator. If L is increased, gamma reduces. We want gamma to reduce. So if RL happens to, okay, just write down this. So inductor is effective, inductor filter is effective for small RL and very large L. That means it offers as a block to AC, isn't it? AC is, it is allowing, F is very high, so inductance is less. It allows AC to pass through and it is blocking the AC values. So now let me show you what we are talking about. The next case is, if you are considering an open circuit, if you consider an open circuit where RL tends to infinity, open circuit means RL is infinity. So when RL is infinity, what happens to this equation? When RL tends to infinity, almost your gamma becomes equal to root 2 by 3. Because our RL is very large compared to omega L, all the other factors are neglected, it is just equal to root 2 by 3 and this is equal to 0.48. So this is how you will be evaluating the capacitor filter's value of the ripple.